Hi all. So today I have come up with a new topic. The topic name is Azure Virtual Desktop. And this is a very famous tool right now in the market. So in the COVID situation, a lot of companies are offering their employees to work from home. And they are giving this virtual desktop to connect to their environment. So we'll talk about this tool today, okay, or about a service today. So what this tool all about, right? We will just quickly talk about features. So the first feature I just now talked about, like remote access from anywhere, okay? So that's one of the best features which I have seen. Then, so when you create a VM inside that, so it supports multiple sessions. Okay, so there is a very huge number of sessions you can create under that. So again, it's one of the good feature. After that, you can bring your own desktop servers. Okay, so there is a gallery they have given to you. In the gallery, you can create an image and put into the gallery. And when you create a host pool, that time you can select the gallery. So that is a beauty. Then the fourth feature which I have come across is about the licensing. Okay, so you can bring your own license into this environment or into this service configuration. And then the last but not a least is about the infrastructure setup. Okay, so if I compare this service with a Citrix, okay, Citrix is of course a good tool, but if you set up a Citrix, okay, it takes time, right? If I set up a Citrix in one on-premise, then I need to configure a lot of different components like NetScaler, storefront, then VDA, SQL server, then Xen controller, license server. So there are multiple component you have to configure, and of course setting up the Citrix environment is a tedious task. Okay, but on other side, if I go to Azure Virtual Desktop, is very a faster way to quickly start the service. Okay, and it's readily available. Okay, it doesn't take much time to set up. Okay, so we are going to see that how it works, right? So right now, you can see in front of you that there is a diagram which I have just now drawn. So in this diagram, if you see that I have an on-premise AD, and that on-premise AD are sync with my Azure AD. So I using the AD Connect to sync this directory. Okay. So if you don't know AD Connect, how to configure it, then you need to see my previous video where I explain about how to use AD Connect tool to sync, right? Then the second, this is the one VNet. Under that, my Azure AD is running. And this is another VNet. Okay, under that, you can see I configure the virtual desktop. Over here, this is the host pool, okay, under which I created the multiple host. Okay, and then I have one workspace. So my user from outside connect to this workspace, and this workspace will go to the workspace will send a request to host, one of the host pool, and then the host will provide the machine to that workspace. Okay, and the session will be available to that user. This is how it's set up. And this to both the VNets are interconnected, okay, using the VNet peering. So the setup is very easy, and anybody can do that. Okay, so we'll go to next point. In this, again, every service have some additional prerequisite step which you need to perform. Okay, so talking about a virtual desktop, right? So in virtual desktop, the first thing which you need to understand about the syncing between your Windows Server Active Directory and your Azure Active Directory. So if you, I can show you quickly, let me go back to Azure portal. This is the Raga sync is my Azure Active Directory, okay? And if I go to my virtual machine, this is another Windows AD, sagarcloud.cf, okay? So if I show you quickly, let me minimize it. Okay. So now I have both the AD. Okay. So they are synced. So how do I check that? I can go to AD Connect. And over here, you can see the status. You can see the sync status enabled. That means they're in sync. Last sync is less than 1 hour ago. And password has sync. This is a method through which I have established a sync. Okay. So this is already done from my side. So virtual desktop, where we can go to host pool first. Let me go from this step. Okay, where let me choose a resource group. I will choose ad-rg resource group. Let me put host pool name. Okay, I will choose location as a US as a default. Let me go with the pool. The pool and personal two pool type you will get. Pool is where you can have a list group of host machines. Okay, so here is the two option you can get in load balancing algorithm: breadth first and breadth depth first. So if I choose a breadth first and I need a four session for example, and I have two hosts, then this breadth first, what he will do? He will divide the session between the two hosts. Okay, and if I choose a depth first, then it will allow the fourth session to run on one host. Okay, after that, if the new session comes, then it will allow the next host to take that session. Okay, so this is the difference between the depth first and breadth first. So let me go to next virtual machine. Let me create a virtual machine over here. Let me put a name, VDI desktop. I will keep as of now, no gallery selected. Let me take with this. Okay, done. Okay, so over here, if you can see, I have multiple options available. So I choose the gallery, and over here I can multiple options available. So for example, in your case, you can also choose storage block. If you have an image and that image it get transferred from your on-premises to cloud, then you can select this, and from there you can choose the image name. Okay, in my case, I don't have any customized image. That's why I'm using the available image in this list. So I can go with the Windows 10 Enterprise multi-session. Okay, similarly, if you go down, you can see that you can also get option with the Windows 10 Enterprise multi-session plus Microsoft 365 apps, as well as you can get option Windows Server as well. So up to you, which option you want to select. Okay, so let me put VM. I can put a VM like one for now. So this one VM work as a one host. Okay, and then OS disk I will keep as it is for now. And then let me choose the network. Okay, I'm choosing the AD network right now, AD VNet network. And let me put my enterprise account. So this is, I'm putting my on-premise enterprise admin account. Okay. SagarCloud.cf. Okay, password. Okay. VDI user. Okay, VDI user. Okay, so let me go to next workspace. I can here, I will keep as it is for now. I will configure this afterwards. And then let me validate. Okay, so now let me create this. So it will take some time. We'll wait for some time. So now you can see the host pool is created. So let me go inside the host pool. Okay, so first we will just check the overview. So in the host pool, I put the one virtual machine that would be my host, right? So you can see the first virtual machine is created. Okay, and if I go down, then you can see there is a, in this creation, there is a one more application group is created, and there is a one more application getting created. Okay, so this is ready now. We'll go to next step over here. So let me go back to my PPT. Now the next point is that assign the users and group to Windows Virtual Desktop application group. So this let me go back to my next option, application group. So over here you can see this is automatically got created. Okay, so now I will go inside that and I will give permissions who are accessing this VM. Okay, so let me go to assignment and let me click on add. And Now you can see this. These are the list of users I can add and I can give access. Okay. So the Kaira and Shrestha, these users are sync from my Windows on-premise AD. Okay. And this is the other users. The Ansh, Hema is are the Azure AD accounts. Okay. So what I have done is that I have just created one group. This group contains the Shrestha and Kaira. Okay. So let me click on this. Let me click on select. Okay. So now this group will have access to access the VM. Okay. Remotely. We'll just refresh it. Okay. Done. So let me go back. Let me close this. Let me go back to my PPT. And the third step is that set up a Windows virtual desktop workspace. Okay, let me show you that. So over here in the serial order, you can see that the next step is workspace. So let me create a workspace over here. So the user will connect to workspace and workspace will redirect the traffic to the session. Okay, session host. Let me select ADRG. Workspace name, I can give the workspace name is VDI. Workspace. Okay. Same workspace one. The description I will keep it as it is. East to West. Let me click on application group. Register for application group. Yes. Okay. Register for application group. Let me click on this and let me click on this and let me select. Okay. Let me click on add and now I have just click on select over here. Okay, and now, so let me create. Now let me go to tags and then review and create. Okay, so now I'm creating the workspace. Let me click on create. Okay, so we'll see. Again, it will take some time. So I will pause the video for some time now. So now my VDI workspace is created. Okay. So this, let me go back and over here in this, this step also get completed. Okay. So I have done with all the three steps, creating the host pool, then giving the permission to the host pool and then creating the workspace. So this step, three steps have been completed. Now we'll move to next testing part. Okay. So testing part, there's a multiple way to access the virtual desktop. Right now, I'm just copying this particular URL and I will paste it into the browser. We'll see how what will happen here. Okay, let me copy paste this and let me go back to the browser and I am pasting this here. Okay, let me paste it. We'll see what happened here. Wow. So let me click on this. Now you can see the workspace. Okay, session desktop. Oh, workspace one. The workspace one is a friendly name. Let me click on this. Okay, let me choose clipboard as of now. Click allow. So now you can see the username, Kaira. Okay, so I am just the Kaira username is got sync from my on-premise AD to the Azure AD. Now I'm using this account to log in. Okay, this account already given a permission through VDI user group. Let me put my password here. Okay. Okay, so you can see that? Yes, now you can see the desktop is in front of you, right? Now we can see the version. We can quickly just go to, okay, we can see properties. Okay. Here we can see that Windows 10 Enterprise version. Okay, now, and this VM is already part of domain directory, sagarcloud.cf, which is on-premise AD. Okay, and then Kaira is already access on this. Okay, only thing right now which I can show you is about Office. Okay, the Office which I haven't taken right during this creation. So I think this won't be available to me directly. Okay, I have to purchase it. Okay, for it I have to create an account and then I can use it. But if you choose another image having the Office 365, in that case you will not get this pop-up. Okay. And then similarly, this session desktop will allow you four sessions at a time. Okay. If you have multiple users, you can do it. So you can expand it for longer user base as well. Okay. So I think I'm done with my demo. If you have any questions, please let me know. Okay. Please comment. Give your feedback to my video. And if you need, I can check and I can reply back to you.